Ever since MediaTek announced their Dimensity chipset, I've always wanted to try a phone with the chip. Today I have with me the Vivo V21 and it's powered by the MediaTek Dimensity 800U. In this video, I'm going to tell you all you need to know about this phone and also answer the question, who is it made for? If this is your first time here, welcome. For my regular subscribers that always come back to watch, I want to say a big thank you as well. The Vivo V21 comes in at the selling price of $388, equivalent to 159,000 Naira. But is the price tag justifiable? Especially given that other phones like the Redmi Note 10 Pro and Tecno Camo 17 Pro are available in the market. Well, we are going to go in depth and compare this phone to other phones that it's competing with to give you a clear understanding of where you might want to spend your money. This review unit was provided by lombardair.com, and if you are interested in buying the Vivo V21 or any other phone in Nigeria, you can visit the website. I have links in the description. They accept pay on delivery to any city in Nigeria. The website is friendly and easy to use. They always sell at recommended retail prices, so make sure you check it out. Just to let you know, before I publish this video, I used the Vivo V21 for over a week, and everything I say in this video is my own opinion. Apart from the Infinix Note 10 Pro that I've seen, I don't think there's any other phone that comes close when we talk about design. The Vivo V21 has a stellar color combination regardless of the color variant you go for. I have the Sunset Dazzle and it has a rainbow effect that shines depending on how the light reflects on it. The Vivo V21 has a plastic build and boy, this thing is a fingerprint magnet. There is a TPU case inside the box and you can use it to reduce the fingerprint stains. The phone has an optical in-display fingerprint scanner that is a bit fast. It's definitely not the fastest, even against the Oppo Reno 5. We have a water drop notch display and it feels dated. The competing brands here are giving you a punch hole camera cutout that is more trendy. We have a sizable chin and bezel, but we can't complain, especially because we have a water drop notch display. This phone doesn't have a headphone port, but Vivo added an adapter that can be used to connect a headphone. We have the USB Type-C port, speaker and SIM tray at the bottom. The speaker is quite loud and okay. The volume rocker and unlock key are on the right side. The phone supports dual SIM cards, but if you want to use an SD card, then you have to sacrifice the second SIM slot. There is a second microphone at the top and another speaker for calls. The phone has a boxy feel and some people might not find it comfortable to hold. I personally prefer phones that have slight curve at the back. They provide me with a better grip. We have a triple camera cutout at the back and it complements the overall aesthetic of the Vivo V21. The phone has an AMOLED display and it's very bright. We have a 90Hz refresh rate here and you can choose to use the standard 60Hz to save battery. There is an option to switch between 60Hz and 90Hz refresh rate as well. For less, the Redmi Note 10 Pro is offering you a 120Hz refresh rate. We have a 6.44-inch display here and I find it comfortable to use with one hand. The resolution is 1080p, but you can now stream higher than 1080p content on YouTube with the Vivo V21. I find the display contrast and bright when watching content or playing games. Talking about games, I always make sure to max out the refresh rate to get better animations when I'm playing. The display is bright outdoors and you can set it to auto brightness if you like. It can get to as high as 700 nits outdoor with auto brightness on. You can play with the colors of the display in the settings and set it to how you want. You can also change the font size and style in the display setting. I have a tips and tricks video in the description. You can check that after watching this video. Dark mode here will help you save battery since it's an AMOLED display. The display here is AMOLED, so it's up to standard with what other mid-range phones are offering. It is also responsive and fast, and scrolling through social media and playing games is very okay on the display. This brings me to one of the most exciting parts of this smartphone, but before I dive into that, gently tap on the subscribe button. The phone is running on Android 11 and PhoneTouch OS 11.1. So far, this has to be one of the best software skins I have ever used on Android. The skin looks a lot like stock Android, but not as optimized as stock Android. I haven't seen any advert on the phone or whatsoever. The apps that came pre-installed are not too much like what we have on other Android custom skins. If there is one major thing that keeps this phone ahead of its competition, then it's the software skin. You don't have those intrusive or overloaded bloats and ads like we have on the MIUI or HiOS. Launching apps on the Vivo V21 is fast and I didn't even notice any lag. You can set up a multiple user interface on the phone and have your main part and maybe another part for guests. There are a lot of customization and tricks you can do, and it's normal with every Android phone. If you are into live wallpapers, then you can download and use them on the phone. It has an always-on display and a ton of lock screen wallpapers that you can use. There is an ultra gaming mode here, and you can use it to set various gaming options. Let's say you don't want any call while playing games, you can activate that in the gaming mode. The Dimensity 800U is a decent chipset that handles gaming and other basic tasks superbly. We have 8GB of RAM and it can be increased to 11GB by using some free storage on the Vivo V21. I played games like COD Mobile and a number of other games, and the device was just fine. For those that are interested in the benchmark score, here is what it looks like. The Oppo Reno 5 offers you similar performance within the same price range. I also have a comparison video of both phones coming, so make sure you are subscribed. The storage space is 128GB. It gets warm during excessive usage, and with high refresh rate, the battery drains significantly fast. We have a 64MP main camera at the back, a 2MP macro camera, and an 8MP ultra-wide lens. The rear cameras are good enough when the lighting conditions are good, but you might struggle with consistency. The 64MP main camera takes some decent shots that are very okay. Portrait mode pictures are fine with humans and objects. I love the ultra-wide lens here, and I have used it a lot to take pictures. It's clear, but you get some fisheye pictures as expected with most ultra-wide cameras on a smartphone. The night mode shoots some decent pictures, and you get additional options in the camera menu. You can shoot 4K at 60 frames per second with the rear camera, but no OIS. When you switch to 1080p, you get an optical image stabilization. Here are pictures of the rear camera. Now, one of the major highlights of this phone is the 44MP selfie shooter, and I don't see any other brand competing in this aspect. You are going to get okay pictures here, and I feel the device was targeted as people who use their front-facing cameras a lot. I took a ton of selfie pictures and they turned out good. There is a flashlight on top of the display in case you are in environments that are not well lit. The phone has a dual view, and you can use the front and rear camera at the same time. If you are a TikToker or Instagram Reels creator, you will find the selfie camera useful. This is a video with the front-facing camera of the Vivo V21, and do let me know what you think about the quality of the video in the comment sections below. The audio you are getting is also from the Vivo V21 and it's unedited. We have a 4000 mAh battery on this phone, and I wish it was up to 5000 mAh. Using the device with 90Hz refresh rate makes the battery drain easily. Charging is fast, and it gets to 50% in 30 minutes. There is a 33W fast charger added inside the box of the Vivo V21. You can get up to 8 hours of screen on time when the high refresh rate is turned off. Now, this is very important, and most reviewers don't tell you who a particular phone is made for. Of course, not every phone is made for everyone. Each brand tends to target a particular set of customers with every release. Moving forward, I will answer this particular question in my videos. The Vivo V21 is simply for people who make use of their selfie cameras most of the time. I feel Vivo targeted a specific niche with this phone, and it has one of the best selfie cameras in the mid-range segment. Performance is not super great when compared to other phones, even though it has a lot of RAM. If you are someone that loves crispy displays, then this is very okay, but you can spend less for similar or even better displays. The Vivo V21 tries to set itself apart from the competition with the front-facing camera. But the price tag is hard to justify, especially because you can get most of its standout features minus selfie camera on the cheaper Redmi Note 10s and even the Samsung Galaxy A52. The performance you will get on the other cheaper phones will be on par with the Vivo V21. If you create a lot of selfie videos, then I can recommend the Vivo V21 to you. If this video was helpful, then make sure you like this video and subscribe as well. That's it for this one. Hopefully, I'll be your host in the next video. Peace.